Streaming live from the Philippines, this is Anton Israel of the Nicotine Consumers Union of the Philippines, or NCUP, joined live by my colleague, Bubut Francisco. But before we proceed, I would like to express my sincerest thanks to Ms. Nancy Lucas of the Coalition of Asia-Pacific Tobacco Harm Reduction Advocates for assembling this great idea together and for inviting us over to do a little presentation about what we do in NCUP. Before anything else, before we feature a little slideshow, I would like to introduce my co-host, Bubut Francisco, with whom I will be speaking in our national language, Filipino. Magandang hapon sa'yo, Bubut. Nakamute ka, nakamute. I think Bubut is muted at this moment. You're muted. Okay, now.
Yes, magandang hapon sa'yo, Anton, at ganun din sa'yo sa ating Nancy Lucas, no? Yung ating sa Capra. Magandang hapon sa inyo lahat yan.
Napakaganda. It's very beautiful that we speak bilingual at this moment. I will speak as much as I can in English and you will respond in Tagalog. Napakaganda pakinggan, Bubut. And then we're now international, okay? And we're now international. And we again express our gratitude for allowing and allowing us to present what NCUP does. At ayan ay sa kagandahang loob, of course, ni Nancy Lucas ng CAFRA. And of course, I also welcome all other advocates from across the globe to our mini presentation here on NCUP. As I said, this show covers two segments. First will be the introduction. And on the second segment, we will feature a 21-minute video with Wacky Gallardo, also a colleague in the advocacy group. He represents Vapor Ako, co-hosted by my friend, Jamie Franco. We host a show called Switch Tayo. The aim of that show is to promote the idea of switching. I myself is a smoker for 40 years. When we formed NCUP, I was still a smoker. And until my health deteriorated significantly, so I thought of switching to vaping. Now I'm already about 3 months, no smoke, vape only. And my friend Bubut can attest to that. Di ba, Bot?
Oo, naman, no? At natutuwa. Alam mo, Anton, natutuwa ako at naimbitahan tayo ng Capra na si Nancy Lucas, no? At natutuwa rin ako at maririnig tayo sa buong mundo ngayon at makikilala ako anong advocates ng NCUP. At muli, magandang hapon sa'yo, Anton.
All right. So simulan na natin, ano? I-present ko itong ating logo. Paano ba ito? Please present our first slide, please. Yes, that's it. So this is our logo, the Nicotine Consumers Union of the Philippines. But again, as I've mentioned, NCUP started off as proyosi.org. We are not a pioneer in tobacco harm reduction advocacy in the Philippines. We are a latecomer, per se, because we started off as a smokers' rights activist. And the organization we carried was proyosi.org. We represent about 20 million, estimated 20 million smokers at that time. And we encountered a lot of difficulties when it comes to ordinances. The LGU, the local government units, have imposed stricter measures. They fine people, poor people, people who do not even have the capacity or the means to pay the fines, whether they were on the way to the market to buy food, and then it ended up to the fine because the enforcers were victimizing these people per se when it comes to locating where these smokers are. So It is quite an infuriating situation that happened here in the Philippines way back 2015 up to 2020 before the pandemic. So because we'd been approached by some of those who switched to vaping, as the government is already inching its way to impose the same measure, the same strict rules as they have had successfully with smokers. Now they've turned their focus in imposing the same measures against vapers. So some of the vapers have approached Pro-UOC, maybe we could team together and represent us in this fight against, how would you call this? Tyranny or the arbitrary rule being imposed against tobacco users and vapers. So we developed the idea of fusing, integrating the idea, but we need to develop first a common ground before there is some sort of an adamant reaction or an adamant impression, because vaping was marketed as a anti-smoking tool, as something that a replacement for smoking. And there is a divide, which is obviously cannot be denied, a divide between smokers and vapers. Now we need to find a common ground. We saw that the linkage is found on nicotine enjoyment. Vapers, smokers alike, enjoy nicotine. So we aspire unity regardless of consumers' preference. If you prefer snus, if you prefer tobacco, largas, or pipe tobacco, we act as one as we preserve the values that bond us together as a whole. So that's our stance. And our reason for being is we exist to safeguard the rights and interests of 20 million Filipino nicotine consumers. So that would include those who have switched from smoking to vaping. Still, the numbers are estimated to run about 20 million consumers. So, and to uphold the liberal expression, that's number one, the freedom of choice, especially over how we should personally enjoy nicotine. And we communicate to deliver our cause and to empower consumers with reliable information. Of course, this is being thought about to combat misinformation, disinformation that is sweeping mainstream media. And I have, you see, there was one occasion that an anti-tobacco advocate who happens to be a doctor, we've met this lady doctor several times in congressional hearings, in public hearings, and she was really an outright anti-tobacco antagonist or an anti-tobacco proponent. But now, she has switched her focus to vaping without realizing that vaping and smoking are two different contexts. And vaping, of course, is created for smokers only. So she's entering the domain again of smokers and now has focused their attention, their effort to combat, to squash vaping for good. Now, what NCPUP does is we cooperate, we work in harmony, we act as one with other pioneering groups like the PSIA, the Philippine E-Cigarettes Industry Association, vapers.ph, care of Paul Dato, my friend, and Vapers Ako, HACAP, HARAP, and other groups. So we communicate to deliver our cause and to empower consumers with reliable information, which is currently a very hard thing to do because, again, the media is powerful. The man behind the media is also powerful, feeding them with funds, et cetera, which creates a very difficult situation, which is why we need our strength, to gather our strength, to pull our strength in order for us to develop ways to provide our friends, the consumers, with better informed decisions. Now, who we are? NCUP is a legitimate organization. It is a non-profit outfit that's been registered with the SEC in November 12, 2018. ProYoC likewise was a SEC registered organization back in 2016. And on top of that, we carry a vision. We are an organization promoting the principle of accommodation, social inclusion, and regional and the reasonable enjoyment of rights made available to nicotine users and non-users alike, providing a voice for smokers and vapers in the perspective of consumers on local health and trade issues. Now, this there is a battle between advocacies outside the perspective of consumers. They view nicotine use differently. They view nowadays nicotine as the enemy, which it never was. Now, and I think that our lawmakers should be reminded that vaping was necessitated. It was something that was invented because of the stricter rules being imposed against smoking. Again, the principle of invention as being the mother of necessity, the vaping, the vapes or the harm reduction methods known as electronic cigarettes was necessitated because of the stricter rules being imposed against smoking. Without, of course, the nagging force of anti-tobacco proponents, anti-smoking proponents, I doubt if vaping would have been surfaced in the first place. So we are presenting a perspective of consumers, but our lawmakers, those who want to restrict nicotine use, are not even smokers. They are not even vapers. So how can they see the value and the merits of our what we stand for? Now, on the third matter, a continuously growing membership of adult nicotine users proactively responding to the dynamic demands of society. Now, since this whole location that we are holding right now coincides with the holding of the COP9 of the WHO Framework Convention on Tobacco Control, it is worth mentioning that INCO, the International Network of Nicotine Consumer Organizations, had developed some questions that need to be addressed there. But again, it is quite unfortunate that NGOs were not allowed to participate. And most of the NGOs that are participating right now are Bloomberg funded. So, but yan ang ating problema ngayon, no? Bubot. May I call on Bubot, please, to react over what I have presented. I think we lost transmission. I lost transmission with Bubot. Anyway, let me proceed. So proceed, as I proceed, it shows here with the dossier that was prepared by the International Network of Nicotine Consumer Organization. It says Bloomberg, the whole, the WHO, and the vaping misinfodemic. And it says here, that's why INCO was compiled this dossier, because Bloomberg, the WHO, and the vaping misinfodemic coincide with the COP9, the FCTC, as well as this program, of course, coincides with the COP9 FCTC WHO. And more than 400 NGOs are represented at COP26, but the NGOs representing COP9 are mostly Bloomberg-funded and denying a voice to the very people affected by COP9 decisions is not a good look. It's a violation of human rights. Definitely, the NCUP recognizes that it is a violation of human rights when we are deprived of what we need, of things that we need to cope up, These people don't realize that smoking is a very, very hard habit to break. More harder than drug addiction. Now, Bubut, I think you're back. Please unmute Bubut, please. For I would like to solicit or elicit his reaction. Bubut? You're still muted.
At naipaliwanag mo lahat sa kanila yung mga ating alituntunin ang ginagawa ng NCUP file o NCUP eh para sa ating karapatan ng mga naniligarilyo at mga gumagamit ng vape. Natutuwa naman natin ako at naimbitahan tayo natin si ano, no, Nancy Lucas sa Katra upang malaman din nila na kung sino talaga si ang NCUP file
yan sa Anton. Oo, siyempre sinabi ko nga, ipinagpauna ko na ang NCUP is not or was not a pioneer in terms of tobacco harm reduction. Tayo ay huli na, no? Nang tayo ay pumasok sa arena ng harm reduction. Dahil unang-una, of course, ako eh, hindi na ako naninigarilyo. Ako ngayon ay isa ng vapor. So nakita akong pagkakaiba. And ikaw still a smoker, maybe we could like to consider switching to vaping very soon.
But, yes, you're right, Pa Anton. No? Maybe very soon or maybe tomorrow na.
Okay, so let me continue. Ano? Dahil there is an ongoing conference called the COP9 COP Conference of Parties. Regarding the WHO Framework Convention on Tobacco Control, and the Philippines is among the most mentioned countries that has been mentioned in the agenda because, as you know, there was an event or there was an occasion at the Congress, the Philippine Congress, when Bloomberg was mentioned there, and a sort of a digging of evidences revealed that Bloomberg intervened. Through the funding, through its mechanism, intervened and was able to penetrate the FDA. So itong pagpasok ng Bloomberg sa FDA, of course, nakaka-discarril ito ng direksyon. We know for a fact that FDA is introducing arbitrary, capricious requirements in their in talks, no, when it comes to the regulations that they would need or they would want to impose. Napaka-capricious. Hindi maabot compared to the EUA in terms of allowing injectables to be released easily. When it comes to vaping regulations, it's too strict. It was as if that you are registering something that is a truly restricted item or restricted formulation. So I think that that's one of the counter productive methods that is being introduced or being utilized by this group in order to curtail further the use of harm reduction methods that would benefit millions of smokers. Again, let me continue with this material being provided by INCO. So, according to the dossier, there are 9 reasons why we should question Bloomberg and the WHO's anti-vaping stance and approach. On question number 6, or reason number 6, it says here, the alleged case of influencing tobacco control measures in the Philippines. So, according to the media in the Philippines, concerns have been raised within the country's parliament that its FDA, through the leadership of Domingo, received funds from Bloomberg groups to support the implementation of the National Tobacco Control Program. Of course, we have a document that we were able to source through the internet saying that there are purchases made. There were purchases made on behalf of this Bloomberg project. It's stated there. there were purchases made in order to cover something like a Bloomberg project. Okay, so this was discovered, and the deputy speaker Rufus Rodriguez said that there was really is reported to have recently questioned the FDA why it accepted funding from the Bloomberg external international groups in exchange for the issuance of predefined policies, something which is against the law in the Philippines. So Rodriguez is quoted as saying that the FDA allowed itself to be influenced by money from external international sources. So this is quite a scandalous, no? To whatever proportion that might be, it depends on one's judgment, but this is quite alarming how this mechanism in cahoots with the medical cabal, in cahoots with other personalities that have been been working against tobacco use, against alternative use termed as tobacco harm reduction methods, are still are still active in promoting the idea that nicotine is dangerous. Now, but we recognize that the focus and the attention that they're promoting at the moment has switched from smoking to nicotine use. So malaking pagkakaiba yan. Magkalaking pagkakaiba yan, because nicotine is not a dangerous drug. No, parang kape lang yan. It's comparable to coffee or to caffeine. And yes, it is addicting, but of course, our body regulates how much we should intake. No? It is not something that nicotine patches can do. Nicotine patches, you cannot control what gets inside unless it is prescribed by a doctor, because the body may not be able to detect, no, when is enough. But when it comes to smoking, when it comes to vaping, of course, we know when to stop. Di ba, Bot? Alam natin kung kailan tayo titigil.
Gumagamit tayo ng halimbawa sigarilyo o kaya ng vapers, alam natin kung saan tayo titigil. Pero pagka yung sinasabi mong yung patches, hindi natin alam kung saan tayo titigil doon. Eh. Tama ka dyan, Anton.
Yes, tama tayo dyan. Ano? At yung iba, there's a danger there, because when you overuse it, when you put patches, the reaction, it delivers, the nicotine delivery, you cannot, of course, determine right at the very moment when it starts to invade your body, kung naparami, you know. If you put in a lot of patches, that's very deadly. No?
Yes.
But when it comes to vaping, when you have enough, you stop. When you need more, you start. Yes. So there's a big difference. Now, I attended a seminar presentation last Monday. And this seminar presentation was sponsored by the Commission of Human Rights, no, through the efforts of HARAP, Harm Reduction Association. And dito, Bot, may nagsalita na isang abogado presented by a lawyer, and he asserted that deprivation of harm reduction use. If you are being deprived by the government to use any of these methods, which is bound to improve your health conditions, that might be considered as a violation of human rights. Of course, we have freedom, and we are bound by ourselves to look for alternatives, which we deem beneficial for our health, diba? Pero kapag yan ay pre-event, when that is being prevented from you by the government itself, or by the LGUs, or by those proponents against nicotine, against tobacco, then they might be liable for some violation when it comes to human rights. They're not just depriving us of enjoyment. They're not just depriving us of what we need, but they're depriving us of the alternative measures that are available for our better health. Kita mo ba? Nakakita tayo ngayon ng bagong avenue na pwede nating suutan na para maihatid natin ang ating tinig ng mas malakas, Bubot. Human rights violation, pwede. Sasama ka ba dyan, Bot? Please unmute na, Bubot, please. Teka, naka-unmute ka pa eh.
Kasama mo ko dyan. Ay, alam mo naman na kasama ako lagi kung nasan ka nando dun.
Salamat naman, bro.
Kanton?
Yes. And just yesterday, the Senate hearing, the interpellation for a vape law that is being forwarded by Senator Ralph Recto. Again, there was a sort of it is being held again on delay or on abeyance because the supposed interpellation which should have taken place last night was postponed until November 22. And many of our opponents were quite jubilant because of the delay's cause. Now, there was also an exchange of heated arguments between two senators over that issue. Okay, but we are about to close because our friends over at CAFRA will be playing a 21-minute video featuring myself, Jamie Franco, and our guest, Waki Gallardo. Yan ang second portion natin. So before we close, both reminders, please.
Oh yes, reminders to our sa ating mga kayosi, no? Lagi tayong tawag din responsable sa ating paninigarilyo at ganun din sa ating mga vapers. Parang nang sa gayon hindi na tayo talaga pinapansin. Yan lang kaantan at ang papasalamat ako kay Nancy Lucas sa kanyang pagkaka-imbita sa ating programa at natutuwa ako at na-broadcast o nailabas mo lahat ang iyong mga hinain sa ating mga alam mo na yung mga lalo na yung kay Bloomberg, no? Alam mo naman tayo sunod-sunod lang tayo dyan. At hindi rin natin, kung di siya titigil, hindi rin natin sila titigilan. Yan, kanto.
Yes. And of course, for the information of everyone, we believe, the NCUP believes that the whole architecture to where this cooperation between Bloomberg and the anti-tobacco groups and how they penetrated certain government agencies was not created overnight. It took years, perhaps a decade, to develop the relationships and to what is now coined as something that we, the Filipinos, our co-advocates in tobacco harm reduction in the Philippines, must guard ourselves up against, no? It's something that has been developed, the relationship with them spans almost a decade in my assertion. Okay, so with that, we were closing this episode. We will be back on Friday, same time on November 12th. And I will be joined then by my co-host, Jamie Franco. Of course, Bubut Francisco is a regular co-host over our show, NCUP Files, a show that's being spoken in our own language. And with Jamie Franco, Switch Tayo is another program delivered to you in Tagalog and in English. Again, thank you very much for the S-Scope program, the platform, to the CAPRA family, and to you, Nancy Lucas, for bringing this together and for having us in our time to present our case. Thank you so much. Till then.
first episode of Switch Tayo. It is a live stream show about vaping, heated tobacco, and tobacco harm reduction. Our hosts, Anton Israel of NCUP and millennial advocate Jamie Franco, will lead the interesting discussion about topics that affect millions of Filipinos.
Kapuloan Pilipinas, magandang gabi. Ngayon ay Hulyo at 30, 2021 at welcome sa premiere episode ng Switch Tayo, ang natatanging programa tungkol sa tobacco harm reduction dito sa Pilipinas. At syempre, ang aking kasama, wala iba kundi si binibining Jamie Franco. Magandang gabi sa iyo, Jamie.
Hello, Ka Anton. Hello to our viewers. How is everyone? Ka Anton, it's been a while. Kamusta po? How are you?
Oh, 30 days ago. So ito, gagawin na natin ito every 30 days, no?
Right.
At syempre, ito ang ating first episode dahil yung ating naging episode last month, warm-up lang yun. Pampagana. At aking nga nabanggit nung nakaraan na tayo ay mamimigay ng mga starter vape sets. No?
Yes, very exciting yan, yeah.
Oo, mamimigay tayo ng tatlo for this particular episode. So ang gagawin lamang ng ating mga participants, ng ating mga contestants, ay magko-comment lang kayo dun sa chat box, either dun sa YouTube or sa Facebook, at doon ay mamimili tayo at iraraffle natin yan gamit ang isang app, at doon na makikilala kung sino ang mga magwawagi at i-announce natin sa susunod nating episode. So, huwag po kayong magatubiling mag-comment at yung inyo pong mga pangalan ay amin pong iraraffle.
So, for sure, maraming sasali dyan ka, Anton.
Sana. Tumalikat na. Saliin mo na rin yung ibang mong kaibigan mo, yung daddy mo.
Opo, PPM ko sila isa-isa na sumali sila mamaya.
Okay. So, nung mga nakalipas, atin nang inanunsyo na ang ating magiging panauhin sa first episode, wala iba kundi si Waki Gallardo.
Correct. Yes,
paper ako. Na Jamie?
So, yes, Ka Anton.
Sino ba si Waki?
Well, sorry Ka Anton, ah, before we introduce our ano, gusto ko lang ulit i-remind yung mga audience natin kung ano ba yung Switch Tayo. So, remind everyone what this show is all about. Switch Tayo focuses on the rights of consumers to enjoy nicotine and why it makes sense to switch for the better. And speaking of switch, me and Ka Anton will represent different generation. So basically, we will exchange ideas and different perspective from an old school and a millennial regarding issues on nicotine enjoyment while getting insights from different experts. So, ayun Ka Anton, I'll introduce na our
Besides, ha? And besides, siguro mapapansin nila na ako'y nagtatagalog, ikaw ay nag-i-English. Ayan
right.
Na kadahilanan para maging universal yung ating approach.
Correct.
Para din sa local audience natin at sa mga international
audience. Correct.
Ikaw na bahala dun sa international.
Yes po. Kailangan ko ba mag-practice sa mga susunod na episode?
Of course. Okay, sige.
Anyway,
bigyan mo ako ng background ni Waki.
Okay, so our speaker for today is a casting director for over a decade now. So, Waki specializes in talent negotiation and booking for multinational agencies here in the Philippines. He is passionate about vaping, having experienced quitting smoking several times without success since he was a teenager.
Okay, so atin ang patuloyin si Ginoong Waki Gallardo. Siya rin po ang taga-pagsalita o spokesperson ng
Yes.
Magandang gabi sa iyo and welcome sa Switch Tayo, Waki.
Hi, Waki.
Hi, everyone. Hi, Ka Anton. Hi, Jamie.
Yes.
Gusto ko na yung pandemic, Waki. How are you?
Ito naman. Hindi ako masyadong lumalabas. Kayo, kamusta kayo?
Okay naman din. Oh, lalo na ako, hindi rin ako
lumalabas. Yes, stay safe at home. Mahirap na magkasakit.
Okay. So, Waki, ikaw ang tagapagsalita ng vapor ako. Baka bago matayo, dumako dun sa ating interview, mabigyan mo kami ng paunang salita, mga paunang pahayag.
Okay. So, ako po si Waki Gallardo and ako po ang spokesperson ng vapor ako. Grupo ng mga consumers sa Pilipinas na nagsusulong para bigyan kaalaman ang mga naninigarilyo tungkol sa mas mababang panganib na produkto ng nikotina. Mm. Layunin ano po 'yan?
Sige, tuloy lang.
Okay po. Layunin po namin na maimpormahan at mabigyan ng kaalaman ang publiko, lalo na ang mga naninigarilyo sa scientific na pag-aaral kaugnay sa mas mababang panganib ng vaping kumpara sa cigarette smoking at kung paano matutulungan ng tobacco smoker na lumipat sa mas bawas panganib na pamamaraan ng na vaping na may mas maliit na amount ng nikotina.
Mm. Very well.
Anyway, Waki, when was Vapor Ako established?
Our group was formed in 2019 and our members are Filipinos who are 21 and above.
Right, but can you tell us more about the composition of Vapor Ako and what it advocates for?
People who joined the group, including myself, were able to successfully quit smoking combustible cigarettes and switch to a significantly less harmful way of enjoying nicotine, which in our case is vaping. We aim to educate the general public, particularly smokers, about scientifically established information on the significantly reduced harm of vaping compared to smoking and how vaping can help smokers switch to a less harmful way of enjoying nicotine. Our group would like to serve as one of the voices of vapers in the Philippines by advocating for the rights and interests of all vapers.
Mm-hmm, right.
This is in line with our group's vision to be a united vaping community. As the spokesperson of Vapor Ako, I make sure we are seen and heard by the government and policymakers by engaging with the media. Through our trusted media contacts, we get to share the latest news and developments about vaping and tobacco harm reduction. The media also helps us to be heard. Mm-hmm. So I help engage with media contacts. We also work to ensure that a realistic and reasonable regulatory framework for e-cigarettes and other less harmful alternatives to cigarettes are adopted in the Philippines.
Well, siguro, Waki, bilang isang tagapagsalita, ikaw ay mismong smoker. At pumihit ka ng vaping. Tama ba ako doon?
Opo, nag-vape po. Nine years na po ako nag-decide lumipat nung...
Mm-hmm.
9 years ako nagsusmoke saka bago ako nag-decide mag-switch to vaping. Mm. Actually.
Interesting.
Well, 9 years is a really long time, and it would take a lot of self-discipline and strong mindset to stop the things you've been doing for so many years, right? So, can you tell us, Waki, what made you quit?
Definitely my health. Kasi my throat was always irritated, and I always had sore throats. Mm-hmm. And I did like the lingering taste in my mouth. Smoking messed with my taste buds, so basically, my overall comfort was affected by smoking. So it used to be rewarding at first when I was younger, but now it doesn't feel good anymore.
Mm. Pero sa aming mga matatanda, sa aming may mga edad, may mga nakakausap ako para sa kanila, yung produkto daw ng vaping ay para lang daw yan sa mga bata. At sa amin, mag-stick na lang daw kami sa sigarilyo hanggang sa huli. Hindi ba awkward o hindi ba nakakaya pag nagbe-vape ang kasing tanda ko?
Hindi naman ka, Anton. Hindi naman. Hindi ako naniniwala.
Wala naman ito nakakaya doon. Actually, ako po yung mga may lasa, yung may flavors pa yung nakatulong sa akin para mag-switch ako sa vaping para mas umukay yung nararamdaman ko, yung kalusugan ko.
Right.
Oo. Saka naniniwala ako na makakatulong din sa ibang tobacco smoker yung paglipat sa vaping.
Mm-hmm. At siyempre dapat may flavor, ano, ah, para hindi kami mahirapan.
Yes.
Yung mga tulad ko hindi mahirapan, lalo na yung mga menthol aficionados or enthusiasts.
Mm-hmm.
Kahit ano naman pong flavor, marami naman pong nagpo-produce ng kung ano-ano flavors dyan.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so going back, sorry, Waki, what was your experience like in being part of the GSTHR panel held last April 18? For everybody's information, the event Waki attended was part of the launch of the Global State of Tobacco Harm Reduction's latest briefing, which is Tobacco Harm Reduction, a Burning Issue for Asia and the Far East. So it was a live debate and Q&A based on the latest briefing from the GSTHR project, which examines challenges and opportunities facing harm reduction work in the region. So, Waki, what was your experience being part of the panel?
Oh, it was an amazing experience. I got to discuss THR with advocates from other countries in the Asia-Pacific region. It also feels amazing to know I have advanced vapor across costs by being part of the panel.
Yeah, napakahalaga nga ng tobacco harm reduction dahil yan ay isang concept na hindi pa nauunawaan ng nakararami sa
mga
smokers.
Mm-hmm.
Yan ay kumbaga parang bago pa lang sa kanilang pandinig. Kaya napakahalaga ng papel na ginagampanan mo, Waki, para yung informasyon na yan ay makarating sa mga smokers, lalo na nandoon sa mga nasa liblib na lugar na hindi nararating ng internet na ginagawa natin ngayon. So tayo ay magtulungan para yung tobacco harm reduction as a concept ay makarating at makonsider ng ating mga smokers na pumihit na at tignan kung yan nga ba ay makabubuti sa kanilang kalusugan. Diba, Jamie?
Yes, Ka Anton. And Ka Anton, for the benefit of everyone, can you tell us what are the policies on vaping in the Philippines? You can answer and Waki can answer the question.
Well, unahin natin si Waki, siyempre.
Okay. Sige. So, as I've shared with the GSTHR panel, sadly, only a few countries in the region have existing laws on vaping and other less harmful alternatives. In our country, the Philippines, the regulatory framework that will govern the manufacture, sale, and distribution of these products is still being developed. The problem is that the World Health Organization and some well-funded anti-vaping organizations are trying to influence the crafting of laws and regulations on e-cigarettes and HTPs. This results in policies that discourage the switch from combustible cigarettes to less harmful alternatives. For example, people who are 21 years and above are allowed to purchase less harmful alternatives to cigarettes. Mm-hmm. If you are a smoker who is 19 or 20 and would like to switch, you can't buy vapes because of age restrictions. Yes, the government allows people younger than 21 to buy traditional but more harmful cigarettes.
Yan nga ang problema natin na Waki dahil sa ngayon, babalikan ko yung katanungan ni Jamie, wala pang malino na policy pagdating sa vaping.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Ang kadalasang ginagawa ng ating mga politiko, kung ano yung galing dun sa smoking policy, pagkocontrol ng smoking, yun din ang ina-apply dito sa vaping, which is of course, ang vaping ay an entirely different thing. Kaya hindi dapat na ito ang i-apply. At gumawa siyempre dapat ng specific at particular lamang sa vaping. Pero alam mo, Jamie, alam mo, Waki, kinokontra yan ng kalaban namin sa sigarilyo. Ayan eh, walang iba kundi si Bloomberg.
Mm-hmm.
Hindi naman niya matatatwa. Hindi na rin maitatago na itong si Bloomberg ay nagpupondo ng mga anti-tobacco groups, anti-vaping groups, sila-sila lang din naman. Yung nandun sa anti-tobacco, pumihit lang, nag-switch na rin sila. Dahil sila ay nag-switch na rin. So, vaping.
first episode of Switch Tayo.
Cigarettes to less harmful alternatives. For example, people who are 21 years and above are allowed to purchase less harmful alternatives to cigarettes. If you are a smoker who is 19 or 20 and would like to switch, you can't buy vapes because of age restrictions. Yes, the government allows people younger than 21 to buy traditional but more harmful cigarettes.
Yan nga ang problema natin na Waki, dahil sa ngayon, babalikan ko yung katanungan ni Jamie, wala pang malino na policy pagdating sa vaping.
Right.
Ang kadalasang ginagawa ng ating mga politiko, kung ano yung galing dun sa smoking policy, pagkocontrol ng smoking, yun din ang ina-apply dito sa vaping, which is, of course, ang vaping ay an entirely different thing. Kaya hindi dapat na ito ang i-apply. At gumawa siyempre dapat ng specific at particular lamang sa vaping. Pero alam mo, Jamie, alam mo, Waki, kinokontra yan ang kalaban namin sa sigarilyo. Ayan, walang iba kundi si Bloomberg. Alam mo, ha? Eta, hindi naman niya matatatwa. Hindi na rin maitatago na itong si Bloomberg ay nagpupondo ng mga anti-tobacco groups, anti-vaping groups. Sila-sila lang din naman. Yung nandun sa anti-tobacco, bumihit lang, nag-switch na rin sila. Dahil sila ay nag-switch na rin. So, vaping, anti-vaping groups yan, ha? Dahil dyan sa Bloomberg na yan. Sana naman eh, masawatanin, mapigilan na yan, ano, Waki? At alam ko, yung ibang mga grupo na international groups ay concern na rin dito sa pagpakikialam na itong si Bloomberg.
Right, yes. Anton. Thank you. And thank you for that. And you know what? I've learned a lot from this one and I want to know more about it. And I want to share this to our kababayan who wants to switch to the less harmful alternatives. Kasi yun nga, it's their right to switch for the less harmful alternatives. So, Anton and Waki, I would like to also call out the agencies such as FDA, of course, to stop accepting foreign grants as it will influence the crafting of laws and regulations on vape and other less harmful alternatives.
Siyempre, mahirap yun para sa kanilang tumanggi. Pero ngayon, mabuti naman, Waki, dahil nabubusisi na yun ang ating mga kakilala o mga mambabatas na nakakaunawa sa kalagayan ng mga vapers na tulad natin. Kaya tayo, magpagpatuloy tayo sa ating krusada, sa ating pinaglalaban at nang sa ganun, ay mailapit natin sa ating mga mambabatas kung ano yung katunay nating kalagayan. So, bago tayo, bago ka namin bitawan, Joaquin, may mga mensahe ka ba na nais mong iparating sa mga kamiyembro ng Vapor Ako?
Wala naman po.
Okay. So, Jamie?
All right. Thank you so much, Waki, for gracing us with your presence dito sa aming first episode. I hope meron pa mga sunod-sunod or mga susunod na episodes with you wherein we discuss the rights and, of course, the effects of using harmless or not harmless, I'm sorry, the less harmful alternatives such as e-cigarettes. Ayun.
Okay. Maraming salamat, Waki. Hanggang sa susunod, ha. Huwag mo sana kaming biguin.
Until stay safe, Waki. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Ayan po. Ayan po ang ating naging panauhin, si Ginoong Waki Galliardo ng Vapor Ako. So, anong natutunan mo, Jamie?
Ako, ka Anton, marami. Especially the fact that napagdadamutan tayo ng karapatan to, alam mo yon, to switch or to choose the less harmful options to alam mo yon, to use nicotine products. And marami po kasing hindi nakakaalam pa sa ganito. We always think that it's okay. We always think na kasi marami pong hindi nakikita yung problem eh. They use the e-cigarettes but they don't see the problem na maraming gustong humarang. So, I guess this is an eye-opener for all of us.
Of course, yung ating mga pinaglalaban, ating mga kaagapay, gaya ng Vapor Ako at ng PISIA, yung ating effort ay naihahatid natin doon sa mga mambabatas at may mga nakaka usap na rin ano, dahil kinatawag tayo para sa mga right. public consultation, particular sa PCEA. At nais ko i-congratulate ang samahan na, ng vapor ako, ng PCEA, dahil pumasa yung mga panukalang yes. batas no, sa mababang kapulungan. Gaya na lamang na itong makikita natin sa Facebook page ng PCEA na yung House Bill number 9007 at yung SB or Senate Bill 2239 ay lumalakad na. E dapat nga tumakbo ito eh. Pero lumalakad na para sa harmonization. Dahil nga kailangan yung version dun sa mababang kapulungan at yung version sa mataas na kapulungan ay mapagsanib, no? At hanggang sa ngayon ay ito niya ang ating pinakaabangan na sana ay maipasa na ito nang walang
yes adla. Looking forward for that, Ka Anton. I think mag-start yata siya ng August or September, still not sure, pero malapit na malalaman na natin kung kung mananalo ba tayo sa ano.
Okay, lang, may humahadlang may mga humahadlang pa rin right. diyan sa Senado. At sana naman ipapatuloy na nila at papasahin na nila at sa ganun ay mabawasan na rin yung load nila, no? Eh, tayo nasa gitna ng ganitong matinding problema. Kaya kung tungkol lamang dito sa vaping, eh, sana palusutin na nila ito nang wala na masyadong deliberasyon
yes.
pa.
At malapit na po ang ano ang eleksyon, hindi na nila maaayos yan. So sana matapos na natin as soon as possible.
Okay. Sige. So yan ha. Maraming salamat sa ating naging panawin at marami ka ring natutunan ngayong
yes, yes,
gabi. And with that, sa second episode ng ating switch tayo, huwag bunyin yung kakaligtaan. Dahil doon po, dahil i-announce natin kung sino yung mga magwawagi ng mga starter kits na kaloob ng switch tayo program.
So don't forget to comment ha sa video na to, and maybe much better to share it with your friends kasi baka manalo din sila, o, di ba, ng ating pa-promo. So yeah, thank you guys so much for okay. watching this, and don't forget to comment down below.
Alright. So yan po. Ha? Maraming salamat, Jamie, hanggang sa susunod na buwan.
Salamat din ka, Anton. See you next month for our second episode.
Okay. So, yan po naging kabuuan ng aming premiere episode. Kauna-unang episode ng Switch Tayo na may masamahan po ninyo kami sa susunod na buwan, August 30, para sa panibago at sa second episode na makapulutan po talaga ng mga impormasyon tungo sa tobacco harm reduction. Muli, ito ang inyong lingkod, Ka Anton Israel. Nag-iwan sa lahat. Sa ngalan, of course, ni Jamie Franco, na ating naging panon ni Suwaki Galerdo, ng NCUP, ng PCEA, ng Vapor ako, nag-iwan po ako sa lahat ng isang magandang gabi.